I'm Ali. Today I'm going to read a story called Henry Keeps Score. Are you ready to listen? Okay, I'm going to read you the story. Harriet Henry calls Mrs. Hedges. Rise and shine, it's time to get up. Harriet rolled over in bed and yawned. 5 more minutes, Mom, she said. Okay. Okay, sleepyhead, said Mrs. Hedges. Henry's eyes flew open. If she gets 5 minutes, I'll get 5 minutes, he said. Henry wiggled down under the covers. No more than 5, or you won't have time for breakfast, said Miss Hedges. 5 minutes before Harriet's mouth, something good, so did Henry. They hurried downstairs, yawned, said Harriet. Pancakes. She took 4, Mom, said Henry. Harriet got 4 pancakes. I only got 3. Harriet got more than I did. Isn't 3 enough for you? Asked Mrs. Hedges. If she gets 4, I get 4, said Henry. Mrs. Hedges gave him 1 more, said Henry, because his mouth was full. After school, Harriet fed the dog and Henry fed the cat. Harriet cleaned the bird cage. Henry took out the garbage. Harriet picked up all the toys. Henry put all his dirty socks in a hamper. She does 3 jobs and I do 3 jobs, thought Henry. Good. When they were finished, Mrs. Hedges asked them what they like for a snack. A glass of milk and 3 cookies, please, said Harriet. A glass of milk and 10 cookies, please, said Henry. 10 cookies, said Harriet. That's too much. You can have 3, said Mrs. Hedges. The same as Harriet. Well, okay, says Henry. That night, Harriet had a pajama party. Judy, said Tiffany, Megan, and Wendy all slept over. They had a great time. I want a pajama party too, said Henry. Okay, said Mrs. Hedges. Who would you like to invite? Oh, Luke and Ted, said Henry, counting on his fingers. And Uncle Ray. Uncle Ray, said Mrs. Hedges. Isn't he old enough for sleepover? Harriet had 4 people, said Henry. If she gets 4, I get 4. All right, said Henry, said Mrs. Hedges. Owen, Luke, Ted, and Uncle Ray come to Henry's bedroom party. They had a great time. The next day, Hedges' family went to the shopping. They started off the bookstore. Harriet got a book and Henry got a book. They went to the clothing store next. Harriet got a sweater, a dress, and a hat. Henry got a sweater and a shirt. I want a hat too, he said. You already have a hat, said Mrs. Hedges, and you don't need another one, said Mrs. Hedges. Harriet got 3 things, said Henry. If she gets 3, I get 3. Not today, said his parents. Said Henry. No fair. That night, Harriet called a friend. I want a phone call too, said Henry. What do you want? Asked Mrs. Hedges. Henry thought, Santa. He said, Santa's on vacation, Henry, said Mrs. Hedges. We'll write to him in December. Then I'll call Grandma, said Henry. That's a good idea, said Mrs. Hedges. She dialed the number. Harriet made a phone call, so I did too. Harriet told his grandmother, I get to make as many calls as she does. Well, I'm very glad you called me, said Grandmother said. The next day, Harriet and Henry went to see the dentist, Mr. Carey. Harriet spent a long time with him. When she came out, she said, I had cavity. Marie gurgled. "A cavity?" he said. "You have a cavity?" "Yes," said Harriet. "Your turn." Dr. Carey looked at every single one of the Henry's teeth. It took a long time, and Harry was nervous. Finally, Mr. Carey patted Henry's shoulder. "Good for you," he said. "No cavities." "No cavities," Henry told Harriet and Mrs. Hedges. "You're lucky," said Harriet. "I know," said Henry. That night, Henry's mom said, "You were brave at the dentist today." "Harriet had a cavity," said Henry. "Do you wish you had a cavity too?" asked Mrs. Hedges, just like Harriet. "No," said Henry. "No, no, no. Just joking," said his mother, kissing him goodnight. Then Mrs. Hedges tucked Harriet in. "You were brave at the dentist today," she said. "Thanks, Mom," said Harriet. Mrs. Hedges kissed her goodnight. "Can I have one more kiss?" asked Harriet. "What do you think, Henry?" asked Mrs. Hedges. Henry thought about Harriet and her cavity. "Yes," he said, "she can." And Mrs. Hedges gave Harry one more kiss. Okay, thank you for listening to my story. Bye.